Definition of crucifixion. Crucifixion was an ancient method of execution in which the victim's hands and feet were bound and nailed to a cross. It was one of the most horribly painful and disgraceful methods of capital punishment. The word crucifixion comes from the Latin crucifixio, or crucifixus, meaning fixed to a cross. So you can just imagine what our Lord went through, and the pain he received that day was so intense. The pain was far greater than a person suffering from cancer went through, and most cancer victims have pain to somewhat numb the pain, but our Lord had nothing. He felt each and every pain sheer through his body. History of crucifixion. Crucifixion was not only one of the most disgraceful forms of death, it was one of the most dreaded methods of execution in the ancient world. The crucifixion of Jesus Christ, Bible story summary. Jesus Christ, the central figure of Christianity, died on a Roman cross as recorded in Matthew 27:27-56, Mark 15:21-38, Luke 23:26-49, and John 19:16-37. Christian theology teaches that Christ's death provided the perfect atoning sacrifice for the sins of all mankind, thus making the crucifix, or cross, one of the defining symbols of Christianity. Take some time to meditate on this Bible story about the crucifixion of Jesus, with scripture references, interesting points, or lessons to be learned from the story, and a question for reflection. Learn more about the Bible story of the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. Timeline of Jesus' death by crucifixion. Jesus' final hours on the cross lasted from approximately 9 a.m. to 3 p.m., a period of about 6 hours. This timeline takes a detailed, hour-by-hour look at the events as recorded in Scripture, including the events just before and immediately following the crucifixion. Jesus Christ made 7 final statements during his last hours on the cross. These phrases are held dear by followers of Christ because they offer a glimpse into the depth of his suffering to accomplish redemption. Recorded in the Gospels between the time of his crucifixion and his death, they reveal his divinity as well as his humanity. As much as possible, given the approximate sequence of events as portrayed in the Gospels, these 7 last words of Jesus are presented here in chronological order. 1. Jesus speaks to the Father. Luke 23:34. Then said Jesus, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." And they parted his raiment, and cast lots. Here we see the nature of his love, unconditional and divine. 2. Jesus speaks to the criminal on the cross. Luke 23:43. Luke 23:43. And Jesus said unto him, "Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise." 3. Jesus speaks to Mary and John. John 19:26-27-26. When Jesus therefore saw his mother, and the disciple standing by, whom he loved, he saith unto his mother, "Woman, behold thy son." 27. Then saith he to the disciple, "Behold thy mother." And from that hour that disciple took her unto his own home. None of his brothers were there to care for her, so he gave this task to the Apostle John. Here we clearly see Christ's humanity. 4. Jesus cries out to the Father. Matthew 27:46-46. And about the 9th hour Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" That is to say, "My God, why hast For Jesus cries out to the Father. Matthew 27:46. And about the ninth hour Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, that is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? In the darkest hours of his suffering, Jesus cried out the opening words of Psalm 22. And although much has been suggested regarding the meaning of this phrase, it was quite apparent the agony Christ felt as he expressed separation from God. Here we see the Father turning away from the Son as Jesus bore the full weight of our sin. 5. Jesus is thirsty. John 19:28-28. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, saith, I thirst. 29. Now there was set a vessel full of vinegar, and they filled a sponge with vinegar, and put it upon hyssop, and put it to his mouth. 30. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, It is finished, and he bowed his head, and gave up the ghost. 7. Jesus' last words. Luke 23:46-46. And when Jesus had cried with a loud voice, he said, Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit, and having said thus, he gave up the ghost. Jesus our Lord paid a sad and painful price for us that day 2,000 years ago when he walked and shed his most precious blood so that we can live. But today, as you can see behind me, the cross still bears witness of what it once stood for. But our Lord came down and rose on the third day. He overcame death, and so shall we. My name is Mark, and I sit and stand this day to proclaim to the world Jesus is Lord of Lords and King of Kings.
Oh, when he wore, when Jesus wore, my sins away, Lord, oh, it's a happy day.